The Alabama sportsman's team are traveling around the state to take a look inside of the trophy rooms of some of the most interesting whitetail hunters in the heart of Dixie. From heart-pounding stories to giant bucks, welcome to Alabama Sportsman's Trophy Rooms.
Hi, I'm Michael Perry, and this is my wife.
I'm Kathy Perry.
And welcome to our trophy room. I've done this mountain lion hunt this past January in New Mexico in the Gila Apache National Forest, and this is probably the hardest hunt I've ever done in my life. It was in January, and I'd had COVID in November. It was 8,000 something feet up, and it was minus 5 degrees, and snow on the ground about 10 inches. Me wearing old country boy, had my muck boots on, and it was rough climbing to get up there and take care of him. He's about 180 pounds, shot him with a 30-06. So, very cool hunt, but it was just rough on my old body. These are my dad's biggest deer. The one in the middle there was a Bankhead National Forest, 130 something inch 8-point, real pretty wide, 19 inch spread. The one on the left is a Black Warrior 9-point, one of his recent kills before he passed. The one on the right is a big old 14-point, over 6 years old. He had sheds of it from the previous year, kind of that's how he knew it was in the area. And it was from the old Cahaba Wildlife Management area. That bow up there in the middle is his first compound bow. Is a Bear Polar 2. And one of the first compounds they come out with, and he killed several deer with it. Here we got a pretty good display of public land animals out of Wyoming. This is a real great trip for family, husband, wife, whatever. You can get quite a few tags. Got 3 pronghorn killed with a rifle here. All 3 of them with two of them with a 30-06, one with a 300 mag. The one on the left shot 360 yards, and the other two is past 400 yards. Both, you know, pretty good ways off, and very interesting hunts. Got some nice mule deer here. The one on the left, Kathy shot with a 30-06 at 240 yards. Then got a couple bow kills, spot and stop. One little whitetail killed on the Cheyenne River coming back from private land to bed down on some old cottonwood bushes. And killed him out of a lock-on stand. And 3 days later, spot and stopped that one, that mule deer there with a bow. So, cool hunts. That's a pretty good one, the rifle there. Here we got a pretty good collection of bear skulls and one little bobcat skull. This is the Arctic grizzly skull. Pretty cool. So, all that's neat, just seeing how they grow and the difference in them. So, the rest of them is black bears with that one down there at the bottom is a bobcat. So, this old jug right here, the story was the Perrys, they all come from Georgia. And they loaded up, so they was going to move, and they're going to load up the wagon, went and got to Texas, and they set old grandma out on a rocking chair, and she got there and said, "I don't like it." So they turned around and come back and stopped in Coleman. And this jug was given to my grandpa full of moonshine to help move somebody. So it was pretty cool. So that bow right there is a bow that I killed my first deer with. It's a Jennings Uniforce. one of the first solo cams they come out with. Kill a mule deer doe with it in Colorado, about 10,000 feet up. Pretty cool hunt. Moose back here. We got some friends, shout out to Rick and Wendy Hamilton up in New Brunswick, Canada. That was his first outfitter tag that he got drawn for. And 1,220 pound moose, 44 and a half inch spread. Just a nice, cool hunt. You know, people talk about turkey hunting and elk hunting, but one of them things, grunt right there, that you can feel that grunt off your chest, and it's very exciting. Shot him with a 30-06 too, so some vine eating. I have another infatuation, but you know, whitetail hunting is our favorite thing, especially public land Alabama. Well, I got a thing with bears, and I run into this guy at the National Wild Turkey Federation in Nashville, and he guides up in Alaska, and he said, "What do you want to do?" I said, "I want to do a grizzly hunt." And he told me all about it. I said, "Man, I'm just a plant worker, work 12-hour swing shift." So I talked to him and let me pay for it over time. It took me 2 years to pay for it. And went up in the Arctic Circle in the Arctic National Wildlife Refuge, way up in the Brooks Range. It stayed daylight, you know, 24/7, and spot and stalked him about 6 miles from the camp. Shot him with a 30-06 also. Just a very interesting hunt. You see them crocs back there. I had them crocs on. I had to put some hip waders on to cross the creek. I had them crocs on. It's actually a river called the Shinjet River. And I had to cross in and go up there to get to him to shoot him. So very amazing and beautiful place to go, Alaska is. Yes, that's awesome. So if I could go there every year, I'd go there every year. We got these old big boys here. These are different. These are brown bears, coastal brown bears, and the coastal black bear over there. Dundee's out around the Cordova area. So these boys get big because they eat a lot of salmon. You know, these grizzlies here, they have to fend for everything they get, and there's no fish. But these old boys get up on the bank while the salmon running and just get big. He's almost 10 foot. Shot him with a 338 Remington mag, a barred gun, a barred one of their guns. So, these whopper got pretty white claws, just an intense hunt. You're sleeping in a tent out there where they live and just basically waiting on them to come through looking for sows. You're just like a rut hunt, basically. So this one over here was a nine-footer. Done these two at the same time, both out of a tent, same general area. Killed the black bear on day 3, a brown bear on day 6. You know, it's funny how they use the same area. The brown bears be out early in the morning, the black bears be peeling around at lunch, and then in the evening you got the brown bears again. I found that shed out there and picked it up and brought it back. Pretty nice moose shed. So this bear here was around 10 years old, and the other one over there, they said he was 14 years old. Then the black bear was around 12. So nice representation of Alaska. Just Alaska is just a wide variety of animals you can hunt. Just an amazing time, plus fishing and just seeing the mountains and everything. We was in the Prince William Sound area on these brown bear hunts. Just a beautiful part of the world. So I like to do a little trapping too. You'll see various animals in here. That's a pretty red fox caught, black warrior mammoth deer. You got to kind of help out with your predators and to save your turkeys and some fawns and stuff like that. So you got to have some management process to help your animals in the areas that you're hunting. So, you know, a lot of people used to trap, but there's not much money in it now. So it's mainly for the benefits of the other animals, just controlling the population. So it's a good thing to do, and it helps you learn how to see how animals use the woods and stuff. Because if you can make an animal put its foot on a 1-inch piece of steel and 30,000 acres, and you're getting pretty good at something. These are the black bears from New Brunswick, Canada. Like I say, Richard and Wendy Hamilton have guided us on these. I got two Popignon ones. They're 300 pounders. Killed one with a recurve. I took my dad's old recurve and practiced up, and then got where I could shoot pretty good at it, and made the longest shot on one of them. That was 17 yards as far as one of them shots. And that's a very cool hunt, but there's a lot of bugs. So they got some bad mosquitoes there. They'll bite through two layers of clothes. But it is a very fun, just relaxing type of hunt. Just like I say, we've got several of them, and there's some good eating too. Black bear's about as good as anything else. These old overhauls here, I've wore them thing probably 20 years and took a lot of animals in them. They finally got wore out, and we just put them right there with our stuff. So this big old brute right here is from the same area, New Brunswick County again, but this, the biggest one in the house, 404 pounds. My little rat here, she took it with a crossbow, shot it 30 yards. I filmed her, I was about 5 yards from her in another lock on, and he was running around, running other bears off, and he made one lap through, and she couldn't get a shot. But the next time he come through, he stopped about 30 yards, and she put the whack on him with that crossbow. So, mission crossbow with a swacker broadhead, done him in. He didn't go about 20 yards, piled up. She shot him at about 9-something at night, and it was like 2 o'clock in the morning before we got that sucker out. He was a heavy one. He had to drag him up a big bluff, and he was something else. But she was excited. Just an impressive hunt, especially for a young woman. So.
Yeah, I loved it. And this is our son here. He was 16 when he shot his first bear. And they've come all from a place called Death Valley. And so I told Rick, I said, you need to name it Perry Ridge. Because all three of us got a bear from that same tree.
Yep, same bear.
And that's cool for a mom and dad and a son to do that.
Yeah, them hunts is very, very good for the family. You can go fishing in the mornings and then bear hunt stuff in the evenings and loaf around, go to towns and stuff like that. That's an interesting part of the world to go see is New Brunswick, Canada. So very diverse with the stuff you can do, deer hunting, bear hunting, grouse hunting, a variety of stuff. Duck hunting, they really love duck hunting too. Here's my first gobbler wild turkey here in Alabama. It's at Fort Rucker Army Base with my brother. He's in the Army. He's been in about 21 years now. Matter of fact, I'm fixing to meet him in Okmulgee tomorrow night and get ready for a week-long muzzleloader hunt. But we went on a turkey hunt, like I say, at Fort Rucker. That's my first long bear to kill. Very cool hunting on public land. And Fort Rucker is public land. Anybody can do it. Just had to go through a little paperwork and stuff to do it. But it's cool. Got a nice little collection of some turkey calls here. Got some old Lynches, got a little snuff can call, Loman snuff can, slate call, just a real soft call. That's a turkey killer right there. So got one homemade that my dad made for me. So got old Eddie Salter one. So cool stuff. There's old moose leg lamp that we had out of our moose. So we try to use everything we can out of something we take, just out of harvest. If it's food and hides and skulls, whatever, we're trying to do something with all of it. Right here's our real passion. Alabama whitetails, all public land, wildlife management areas, pretty much. You got Black Warrior, Wolf Creek, Sam Murphy, and Okmulgee all here. You got the bow kills, muzzleloader kills, and rifle kills. So this old boy right here in the middle, I'm 31 years old, killed this one at Wolf Creek. That's my first good buck. After that, I started changing the way I wanted to hunt and concentrate on areas like I killed him in. And then from there on, this is what's happened after that. So a lot of people are trying to let deer grow older and stuff, but some of your deer, you know, get pretty good size. That's a 3.5-year-old Black Warrior, but this deer here is 5.5-year-old from Okmulgee. So it's just kind of a difference in some of your genes. So it's 3.5-year-old muzzleloader kill from Okmulgee, a good deer. some more 3 or 4 year olds from a Black Warrior, one on the bow. This old guy right here killed last year with a muzzle loader, and that was an Oak Mogan. He was 6.5 year old plus, just an old, wasn't a real big body deer, but just an old cool looking 8 point, just a good deer to harvest. You know, if you can kill a deer 6 year old, you know, it's pretty tough. So, but there's a good variety of deer, you know, good 8 points and some 9 points and stuff. But we love all of them. Right here is Kathy's wall. She's got 3 good Black Warrior bucks and a Black Warrior doe. The one on the left is a 30-06, no, it's a 7.08 kill. Was her first year she hunted with 7.08. She got it, just a very nice 194-pound 8 point. The one in the middle was her first deer with a muzzle loader. I've been trying to get her to get a muzzle loader for years, and finally one year she had a big buck come by her at 75 yards on a muzzle loader hunt. She sat with a crossbow and she said, go get me one.
That weekend we went.
Yeah, we went that weekend to Cabela's and got her muzzle loader. First year she hunted with it, she killed that nice 8 point, 4.5 year old. So. Then she got that doe there. She's a woman that has killed a buck with a bow, crossbow, a muzzle loader, and a rifle on public land. Her first deer she killed with a regular bow, compound bow, at Wolf Creek, man, there. So she's a tough little woman that loves hunting. Sometimes she don't like the real, real cold, but she hangs in there tough. So I'm proud of her and all everything she's done. She shot in a truck buck before.
Yeah, I got to shoot an AON.
Yeah, it's AON truck
and,
buck.
And won a gun and a safety harness. I missed the egg. But I still got the opportunity to do it, and that was pretty cool.
Yeah, I'm proud of her. She's done a lot in her little career there hunting, so she hangs in with me all the time. Everywhere we go, she's right there with me, so we enjoy it. So.
Did you get a picture of me shooting my deer over up there?
That trail cam picture of her deer.
Michael's, yeah,
I
look at
about that.
Michael says, Kathy, you've got a bunch of pictures on this camera, and I was like, what camera? And sure enough, we got back to camp, and it shows where I actually the deer come in and when I shot it.
There's some good trapping, old traps. Pretty good little collection of antique ones. Got one signed by Tom Miranda. You know, he's well known in the outdoor industry as a trapper and a hunter. Right here we got my better deer, the bigger ones. Last year I took this old guy, this old 6.5 year old plus 7 point, bunch of stickers, weighed 204 pounds. At the time, that was my biggest buck to date for body weight. He's just a big old tank, just a old brute. I was proud to take him. So got a few more over here in the corner like. That's a 137-inch 10-point, just a big old 5.5 year old Black Warrior deer. Pretty, good thick horns, a little bit of chocolate, nice sticker. The one in the middle is my biggest Oak Mogie deer. It's a 140-inch rifle deer. Me and Kathy doubled that day. Killed that big 9-point, she killed a little younger buck, but we had a good time dragging two out. So.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. Yeah.
The one in the corner is my biggest rifle buck, 158-inch Black Warrior. Big old, I think they only aged him at 4.5, but he was a big body, just a big old boxy square frame, 13-inch G2, just a beautiful buck. You know, made Alabama record buck and the Buckmaster record buck. So now, after this year, I completed a pretty good goal that I wanted to do is take 3 record bucks with different weapons, a bow, muzzle loader, and a rifle. So first one I got was with a rifle. My second one was this big dude right here in the middle. I've been wanting, that's my goal forever, to try to shoot one and get it in the Pope and Young book. And this guy right here made it, big 142-inch, grossing 9 point, 21.5-inch inside spread. Just, he made all three record books, Pope and Young, Alabama Whitetail Records, and Buckmaster. Just a beautiful, wide frame, just awesome buck with a bow at 25 yards. He was chasing the doe, so. I won't put a trail camera somewhere unless it's somewhere I think I can hunt.
That's right.
So I don't put it on bait or anything like that. If I think I can hunt there, I'll put trail cameras there just to see what's using it and to see if it can work for me to hunt, and then I'll hunt it. I don't mess with them during the season, but it showed me what happened during the season. And when next season comes around, you got an idea of what you might want to do or what you need to do, or if you need to make moves or whatever. So any kind of pinch point, travel corridor, edges, above creek crossing, stuff like that. That's where I run my cameras, to try to help me out, make a plan for the season. So.
And it works. Look what he's holding.
Getting to the big boy. This is, you know, a lifetime dream is to kill a deer that's, you know, nearly a 200-inch deer on Alabama public land, and to do it with a muzzleloader. My goal this year was to kill a buck, to put in record buck with a muzzleloader, so I was going to talk my muzzleloader all year. And this guy, the first day I went and hunted this boy, and I killed him. He was following behind another buck, about 5 minutes behind it. About 45 yard shot. I had him on camera for a couple years. He was using a edge going through like a shelf. And he's only daylighting like two or three times a year during November that I knew of on camera. And he would show up daylight a couple times in November. So I made a plan that I was gonna go down there and start hunting him in November and set him out as much as I could. Anytime I was gonna have off day, I bought a crossbow specifically to hunt him. That way if it wasn't a gun hunt, I'd hunt him on because it's a hard angle shot. I wanted to make sure I could make a good shot by seeing him. Well, the first day I went on the muzzleloader hunt, I worked off Thursday, and the last day of the muzzleloader hunt was on a Friday. I went, and then at 9:45, he come out following another buck, like I said. Shot him with a CVA Optima Long Range muzzleloader that she got me for Christmas one year. 245 grain Barnes, solid copper bullet. He didn't go about 40 yards, piled up. But when I walked up on him, I knew it was big, but I didn't know it was that big. So I walked up on him laying there, and boy, tears started rolling because I knew it was the one that I had on camera, and I knew it was big. I mean, I'm hoping 170s, then they come to find out Alabama Whitetail Records got him at 196 and 3/8, and Buckmaster got him at 195 and 6/8, so the state record muzzleloader kill. He's just an impressive animal. We're going to do him justice and have a full body mount. It's going to be cool. So he's an awesome buck, and just a buck of a lifetime for sure.
I heard him shoot at 9:45, and I was like, man, whatever he's got, it's a big one. Well, I'm sitting in there, and I'm waiting, and I'm waiting. I thought, well, come on. Finally, after 12 o'clock, here he comes, and he's got his sleeves rolled up like this. He's got blood all over him. He said, I got him.
I was tore up. I mean, had to go get some buddies, and it took us 2 hours. I drug him for an hour by myself, then when I went to her and went got some buddies, and took us 2 hours plus with a cart to get him out. So. I think we got to the checking station at 5 o'clock, and I shot him, like I said, at 9:45, and it was a one heck of a day, just an amazing day. So
it's good to have good friends that'll help you.
Yeah. He's got real big, thick mass, and he's just impressive. So plans and sticking with it is it will get you a big buck if you know. You got to be where big bucks at. If you can find their footprint or a shed, anything to find their core area that's outside of the rut, then you got an idea where they're at, and then you can set you up a plan and try to get him, you know, because they're only daylight just a few times during the season that a big buck like this will move in the daylight without being jumped or something like that. So, yeah, they've got this certificate in the other day. Buckmaster Johnny on the spot, boy, just a couple of days after we got it scored, they sent it to me. So, there'd been a few magazine articles and stuff about him already, so he deserves everything he gets. So, certificates and magazine articles, whatever. He's just a monarch of the woods, black warrior monarch. Thank you all for visiting our trophy room. We got to go and get us something to eat. We're hungry, and I got to head out to Okmulgee tomorrow and get her ready where she can go hunting again. And thanks again for seeing our trophy room.